thank you again so much for the opportunity. Our kids are awesome, PRM and Keel, and it was a really great partnership, and we are looking forward to Read Across America this spring, so thank you.
Thank you.
And Mrs. President, before I close, something came to me. I want to thank Mr. Mott and Mrs. O for your hard work and sharing it tonight. And additionally, I want to thank everybody on the Citizen Advisory Committee one more time, and those folks, our phys ed staff, K-12, and our admin team, because as I shared Tuesday night, being 15, that was a big lift. And, you know, another big lift was our eighth grade open house that was November 3rd. Our high school staff and our high school student body that came on that. So we're moving very fast. And speaking of which, I see Mrs. Sutton here tonight. I have met with the Keel and the middle school faculties, you know, talking about climate and surveys. And I put out the olive branch for the opportunity, changing the evaluation model. We annually have a resolution for the board, and we asked one in May and June for both the administrators and the teaching staff and certificated staff. So I put that out there. I met with Stony Brook SIP panel. Next week I'll meet with the Stony Brook staff, and I'll meet with the high school staff on the 5th, I guess, by Christmas. And as far as the student information system, that's an 18-month rollout because that's much better. So we'll see where we are, where we're at. I also hope that the admins, they don't have to be the same email model. Two separate. It makes no difference to me. We know what good instruction is. So we'll see where we land. And as far as curriculum focus, streaming, we had 77 online. So while I would have preferred a packed house, 500 in the auditorium, we didn't get that. That's okay. I'll start with 77 online and 12. So I'll start there in person. So, but we are live streaming Mrs. O's bedtime math on November 30th. She's going to put an alert out there. Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. So it's those steps going forward. So everybody have a great Thanksgiving for those folks who are still here. And Mrs. Portman, that you in the back, right? I'm correct when I said that. So for the track team, we have a conflict because of basketball. And most of our cross country students have basketball away that night. So Mr. Doty is working on bringing that team out in January. So you know, just we were to say recognition in December, but with them not being here in such conflict, we'd like to give them that opportunity to achieve such a high day. So that closes my report.
So we should. Is the
see all the awesome art teachers are doing.
Motion. Second.
I have a couple of just quick questions. This is really sounding awesome. We're working on selecting and volunteering faculty members who are creating benchmark assessments.
This is my home, but I'm going to turn to you before I start.
That's been an ongoing issue to work on benchmark assessments through honors. Through honors. This is Michelle, who is the representative of faculty teachers, grade level. We're simply them across the level, so we're moving on. So that'll help the staff target.
Absolutely, yes. So in addition to, well, the spring and JSLA, the Spark Strong assessments for 3 and up, obviously not ideal, but they're not doing the benchmark assessments in the course there. And looking at where our learning gaps lie, where kids are, of course, if you follow a learning acceleration model, where we are moving to the current curriculum, current grade standards, looking at where holes are and filling that in as needed.
We're still.
And as much data as we can get, in addition to the anecdotal support from some of those. Because there, if you used to talk about this, we used to talk about this as a snapshot or years ago as a Polaroid, but now it's more of a photo op.
True, awesome. I think we had talked about that briefly, but yeah, that's really great. It's awesome. And then the only other question that I had, sorry, we tried to catch up as quickly as we could. The Roxbury teacher, that's where you're sharing what we do.
Right, so we've been in it for a long time, so we actually are quite good at it at this point, if I may say so myself, on behalf of our teachers. We're awesome at it. So we are now in a model school, and they asked if these teachers from Roxbury could come in and observe our teachers so that they can take it back and improve what they're starting out.
What is PR media? Isn't that part of this?
That's not here, but we can talk. Do you want to talk about that when we get to the 4 minutes? It was in the minutes, and maybe somewhere not, at a point lower.
Stonis?
Yes.
Mr. Eisenmenger?
Yes.
Mrs. Fishback?
Yes.
Mr. Gigante?
Yes.
Mrs. Perella?
Yes.
Mrs. Fetchersaler?
Yes.
And Mrs. Dawson?
Yes.
Negotiations or something?
Nothing.
Personnel?
Personnel committee went light this month. We only have 25 items. Agenda items number 1 through 25 represent the personnel committee's recommendations that the voter finds approved. Starting number 1 on page 4, it's a maternity leave of absence. Number 2 is the appointment of Mrs. Combet, so welcome. Thank you for being here tonight. Then we have a long-term math substitute, a leaving replacement mathematics teacher, part-time district school nurse, industrial arts teacher, item number 6. Page 5, then we have additional assignments, which is payments for the Title I supplemental support program. You can see that listed. You have payment for staff members for the COVID test administration at Campbell Stony Brook. You can see that listed there as well. Number 9 is payment for the staff members with the KHS open house. Number 10 is payment for defined class block stipend. And those are personal taxpayers. Number 11 is transition time payments. So you'll see the staff members listed there. Appointment of Mrs. Mulholland under number 12 for District Affirmative Action Officer, as a Title I coordinator, Title IV coordinator, and District Test coordinator. Payment for CPR AED training under number 13. Then we get into non certified staff resignation, paraprofessional teacher training under 14. Then we have the appointment of part time substitute. Resource officer under 15, appointment of full-time custodian at KHS. Number 17 is 45-hour field experience that we're approving. Number 18 is prom director, prom director. Number 19, appointment of day day worker. Number 20, rescind the stipend about the athletic trainer. We talked before about that. And that's it in the personnel minutes as well. A revised co-curricular list is number 21. That's personnel attachment B. The payment, paraprofessional payment for home program is number 22. We have the appointment of substitute teachers under number 23. We'll see it starts at 27 and goes to 23. Number 24 is the appointment of cross varsity head coach. And then number 25 is the revised range of coaching involved.
Motion.
Motion. Second.
And any discussion?
So I'll just mention that, we talked about the athletic trainers and the Eastern personnel committee. So Kelly,
So the pro bono prom director,
I was happy to hear that.
Very excited about that.
Yeah.
We got a lot of excitement in the pro bono.
So will that be like at the end of the year? What's, do you know what the plan is for the show?
Typically what we do is the audition process in January, start rehearsing shortly after that, and we usually aim for a show in late April.
Awesome.
Very happy to be bringing that back.
Yeah. Very cool. Yeah. Awesome.
Can I just ask a follow-up? Where's the stage?
Typically we run it in the high school auditorium.
Okay.
When are we getting the new theater?
New theater.
The new community theater?
And are they using microphones?
Yes.
There are a lot of questions, yes. We started with, do we have a director? The answer is yes, so we'll figure the rest out.
Gotta start somewhere. Ms. Keane.
Mr. Petroselli?
Yes.
Mrs. Burrell?
Yes.
Mr. Gerke?
Yes.
Mrs. Bishop?
Yes.
Mr. Eisenmeyer?
Yes.
Mrs. Thomas?
Yes.
Mrs. Johnson?
Yes.
Policy committee, Mr. Rasmussen.
Well, that's cool. Just three things, three items to vote upon as a group. For the first meeting, the October HIT report. Number two is the recommendation of the superintendent to approve the 2023 school safety and security plan annual review statement of assurance. And number three, the recommendation of the superintendent to approve the first reading of the following policies and regulations. Policy 2425 has to be a virtual plan, so that can be in the regulation. Also on virtual plans, so for distance learning plans, to get that facility, a facility or facility of course for 3 or more days. I believe the manage rights. The one that is in the middle that I jumped over is policy 1511. Board of Education website accessibility. We're also mandatory and updates to the existing policy, which deals with making sure that all the district websites comply with the ADA, so that, you know, among other things, every so often, the Internet Explorer goes out of date, and you have to get up there to learn, and then all the things we set up crash. So we have to make sure that we're complying with the ADA.
Yes.
Mrs. Fishback?
Yes.
Mr. Eisenmeyer?
Yes.
Mrs. Thomas?
Yes.
Mr. Burrell?
Yes.
Mrs.
recommendation is to continue some funding in the amount of $40,260 for fiscal year 22, with a grant for emergency pass maintenance needs. Additionally, approves of Dr. Andre Ferenc for PhDs and bilingual evaluations for 22-23 school year.
Motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
Are there bilingual evaluations for the CLO bilingual fee that the evaluations are for, or are they for our bilingual students?
Two pieces.